Cut. Cut. Please stand.
Please remain standing as we sing the national anthem.
Please be seated. Brothers in an endless chain, Some of you may be familiar with the term, brothers in an endless chain. But you may be asking, what would that term mean for us here tonight? Brothers in an endless chain. Maybe I can give you a bit of an illustration. So, I love photography. It's a great place to hide. It's also a great place to capture moments in truth as it happens and store that to show who we are as a community. So last year, my son was involved in inter-house athletics, under 16, doing high jump for the first time. Nervous as you can't believe. And here he is with, I don't know, 10, 12 other guys, all in different colors, some yellow, some green, some red, some white, and so on and so forth. And here he goes, the first jump. And I've got my long lens, and I'm looking, and I'm focusing on him, and he's nervous. And he comes, and he does his run-up, and he launches off over the bar. You may tell I know nothing about high jump. But he gets over, and the other guys come as well, and they run, and they jump, and they're over. Time for his second jump. Runs, jumps, over, because the bar's now been lifted. But then I noticed something peculiar. Because I'm his dad, because he's my son, I can recognize that not everything is well in his world. I look at his facial expressions as he's standing with the other competitors, and I see he's in pain. But he goes and he runs, and I notice on his run-up, he's in pain. And for the first time in a long time, I see tears running down his face as he's going to the run-up. Of course, I've got the long lens so I can focus on his face. The other competitors are blissfully unaware of this. The crowd is blissfully unaware of this. And he goes and he does the run-up. And he's over. Yay! One by one, the other competitors start falling out. The bar gets lifted higher and higher and higher. And the higher the bar's lifted, the more pain he's enduring. After a while, he couldn't keep it anymore. He couldn't hold it in. And he's lying down, fetal position, holding his knee. I'm not quite sure what he was doing to the knee, but there he is, speaking sweet nothing to the knee. And one or two of the other color brothers come around him. One guy's trying to give him a massage. Other one is holding his shoulder. One's talking to him sternly. Another one is busy, what I can best describe as panel beating his knee. I thought, this violates some kind of health and safety code. But nonetheless, here he is, panel beating his knee, and one guy is just looking him in the face, telling him something that no one else hears. And the bar is lifted high. And the streak marks are down his face. He's now the only competitor left in this competition in his age group. Before you know it, the announcer comes. Ladies and gentlemen, we are now at the precipice of history. The next jump could determine a new record in this category. The school is 181 years, new record. Let that sink in. And there he is, still in pain. The color brothers are still busy administering their ministrations on him. No first aider in sight. Maybe I shouldn't have said that. Nonetheless, here they are. They're busy with their ministrations on him, and massaging, and the panel beaters coming out. And then he stands up. And through my long lens, I notice something has changed. Something very different has changed. Remember, these are the competitors. These guys are wearing different colored t-shirts. They get up. They walk away. He's left standing alone. Because only he can jump. No one else can take his place. It is his responsibility to go over that bar, because that is the goal. But I see him, and his very persona has changed. There's a steel in his gaze. And he stands, and he prepares, and I've started noticing his process. He would stand, he would look down, he would not look up because he's been watching the goal the whole time. He's now steeled himself. And he does this particular when he starts off, he does this side move thing. I'm not quite sure if it's to impress someone, but he does this side move thing with his legs, almost like a speed skater. And then things come into a line as he's running up. And I notice a difference between this run-up and all the run-ups before. Something had changed. And here he is. He's going straight, and then he changes 90 degrees. It was scary how fast he changed. And now he's almost running parallel with his high bar, which, by the way, is the same height as me. Bit of a sobering thought. And he comes. And he launches off on his troubled knee that I could see was the cause of the pain. He launches off that troubled knee. And for the shortest eternity, he's left in suspended animation. That bar right there. And his arm goes over. And he's twisted so that his chin is facing the sky. His torso goes over. His legs are at 90 degrees, storing up energy. His butt goes over. And in the last moment, he flicks his legs. And he goes over. And there's absolute silence, except for the crowds who are now cheering, "Loca, loca, loca," and they're going wild. Even Littlewood is going, "Yay." And then that sweet, sweet sound of those oversized pillows going poof, as they are the first to herald a new school record has been met. So what had happened? And what does that have to do with us here today? Brothers in an endless chain. Tonight we are here to celebrate a group of guys and their families. We're here to celebrate the victories. There's a perspective in our society that your identity is based on what you own, what you've achieved, or what everyone thinks of you. May I challenge you on that? Brothers in an endless chain. That your self-worth cannot be on what you've achieved. Your self-worth cannot be on what you own. Because those things change. Interesting thing. After that record was broken, my son goes to several other zonals, athletics meets. Remember, this is the first time he's doing it. He breaks his personal best several times. And I've got this picture of him going over this high bar where he's tall, he's 6 foot, where the bar is higher than him. And he defies gravity going over that bar. That would have been impossible unless he had those color brothers encouraging him, being a brother in an endless chain. So what does that have to do with us here tonight? Everything. We are here not just to give awards. We are here to celebrate victories as individuals and as a community. Keep that in mind as you cheer. Keep that in mind as you remember all the hard work you've put in. Boys and families, welcome to tonight's award ceremony. My name is Eugene Renz. I am part of the governing body as a parent member. May you enjoy the celebration that we have for you tonight. Thank you.
Good evening, and welcome to our annual prize-giving ceremony, a highlight on our school calendar. A special word of welcome to the following people: members of the academic staff, members of the SGB, the parents, guardians, and family of our boys, special guests and visitors, Mr. Kannemeyer, circuit manager from the WCED, former and current campus headmasters, I see Mr. Cedric Pullman in the audience, And the most important guest of tonight's function, our boys, the prize winners of the past year. It is very important for modern organizations to keep on improving by building on past traditions as a foundation for the future. Schools and many organizations are often referred to as centers of excellence. Mark Webster reflects on the question of what organizational excellence means on the Real Organizational Excellence blog. Excellence can be defined as the state of possessing good qualities in an eminent degree, but this definition of excellence is difficult to apply in any tangible and meaningful way. However, both organizations and schools cannot succeed without people. Every successful organization or school needs effective people management, leadership, policy and strategy, partnerships, resources, and processes that will lead to people results, customer results, and societal results. With the emphasis on people, Winston Churchill defined excellence as caring more than others think is wise, risking more than others think is safe, dreaming more than others think is practical, expecting more than others think is possible. Mark Webster concludes that organizational excellence can therefore be defined as delivering superior performance that meets and, where possible, exceeds the expectations of the organization's stakeholders. The performance of an organization is therefore central in measuring whether expectations have been met and whether stakeholders have benefited by being associated with the organization. There are various models available to measure performance. By looking back on the year 2023, the performance of Wynberg Boys can be measured by using a well-known performance management tool, namely the Business Excellence Model of the European Foundation for Quality Management, also known as the EFQM Excellence Model. This model emphasizes a 360-degree holistic approach to performance improvement and focuses on performance enablers and performance outcomes. The EFQM Excellence Model is therefore a practical tool to help organizations measure where they are on the path of excellence, to help them understand the gaps, and to then stimulate solutions. For the purpose of Wynberg Boys High, I will focus on the following enablers. Firstly, leadership. Secondly, people management. Thirdly, policy and strategy. And finally, resources. I will also evaluate the following performance outcomes. Firstly, people results, and finally, key performance results. The first enabler for success is leadership. The correlation between a successful organization and leadership was already emphasized by Jim Collins in 2001, when he demonstrated the ability of leaders to take a company from good to great. At Wynberg Boys and during 2023, a concerted effort was made to develop leaders and to empower the staff to take ownership of their areas of involvement. The senior executive has been extended, and all the areas of the school is now fully represented, namely the four pillars: administration, finances, marketing, human resources, and operations. During the year, the temporary positions of vice principal of sport and vice principal of culture and service became available, as these two pillars of the school have become very demanding to manage. Mr. Alan Herbert has been appointed as the vice principal of sport and Mrs. Natalie Cogg as the vice principal of culture and service. Mrs. Juanita Wilson has been appointed to champion the leadership portfolio at the school. The house system that previously comprised of 8 houses has been extended to 10 houses. 2 new house heads, namely Mr. Stefan Potgieter and Ms. Jocelyn de Mink, has been appointed to lead Tenant House and Garrison House, respectively. Mr. Duncan Woods, a performance coach, addressed all the winter sports captains on leadership and game management in 2023. The second enabler for success is people management. Our academic staff meets weekly on Fridays for staff development sessions, and we've started the year off by sharing best practice in classroom management and best practice in tutor groups with the staff, building on the development sessions of 2023. The school has appointed a seasoned marketer, Ms. Claudia Leforelli, to provide direction and impetus to our marketing strategy and initiatives. We have also continued in 2023 to provide opportunities to our boys and manage their involvement via the four pillars that are the foundation of our approach to ensure a well-rounded education. Our boys are fully represented, not only by our head prefect, deputy head prefect, the prefect body, and the RCL, but also by our grade prefects, and house captains, and boys representing the various portfolios at the school. The third enabler refers to policy and strategy. The school's finance policy was updated in 2023 by our finance department, as well as a group of committed and dedicated governors representing the school governing body. The school governing body has now come to the end of their term, and please give them a round of applause for their contributions. Part of the finance policy includes the relevant procurement procedures and preferred suppliers to enable good corporate governance and to ensure that due diligence is followed. Through our Vision 2025 strategy, the school is still fully committed to excellence in the following areas: education innovation, sporting excellence, multicultural excellence that includes service, a pastoral caring approach with an emphasis on building resilience and empathy, staff well-being, 360-degree communication, focused alignment with our feeder schools, tertiary institutions, and industry, and finally, identifying and exploring resources. And the final enabler refers to our resources. We are proud of our highly experienced and dedicated staff, and we make a concerted effort to connect, coach, and celebrate our staff. Staff recruitment, staff development, staff compensation, and staff retention are all part of our vision towards 2025 and beyond. From a financial perspective, Wynberg Boys High provides a fantastic return on a parent's investment in their son's education. We have managed to keep our annual increase in school fees extremely reasonable for 2024 and without compromising the quality of a Wynberg Boys High education. This brings me then to the following performance outcomes of the EFQM excellence model. Firstly, people results, and finally, key performance results. There is a direct correlation between the successes of Wynberg Boys High in 2023 and our staff. Without their commitment and dedication, ample opportunities will not be created for our boys to perform and excel on the national stage. I also want to ask you to give our staff a round of applause for their contribution. Twenty-seven boys of our class of 23 achieved an A aggregate. Jared Ben excelled by being placed second nationally in the NSC examinations at the end of 23 with an aggregate of 96.14%. He was also placed first nationally. He was also placed first nationally in physical sciences with a staggering 100%. Jared also achieved 100% for mathematics. This is the first time in the history of the school that such accolades and recognition have been bestowed on a Wynberg boy. Several boys were selected for the province in various sporting codes in 2023, and we are especially proud having produced both the SA School's rugby captain, Kola Nyali, and the SA School's cricket captain, Benny Hansen, in 2023. They followed in the proud footsteps of Zach Porthon, who captained the SA Schools rugby side in 2022, John James, who captained the SA Schools cricket side in 2022, and Anik Burton, who captained the SAFA under-19 soccer side in 2023. The choir, concert band, and vocal ensemble all achieved category medals at the Cape High Stedford in 2023. Benjamin Buddy Harley was awarded 3 solo singing category medals at the Cape High Stedford, whilst Damien Philander passed his final Piano Grade 8 Royal Schools of Music examination with distinction. 3 boys entered the Cape Town Drama High Stedford in 2023 for individual monologues and attained excellent results. Joel Isaac Stevenson was not only awarded a gold diploma for his entry, but was also awarded the Cape Town High Stedford overall medal for the best monologue. This places him in the top 10 in the country. Our boys were fully involved in service and supported our local communities in 2023 in various initiatives. The Sandwich Project, Sanitary Pad Initiative, various beach cleanups, the Easter Eggs Collection, and Christmas Project, to name but a few, were well supported and well received. And finally, our key performance results. According to the EFQM Excellence Model, excellence within an organization is also about the key performance results and how the goals relating to its core business have been realized. Should one ponder the year 2023, the following key performance results stand out. Firstly, academics. 175 full-time candidates wrote the 2023 NSC examination. The school achieved a 99.4% pass rate. Of the 175 full-time candidates, 87.4% achieved a baccalaureate degree pass. At the end of 23, the grade 8s achieved a 99.1% pass rate. The grade 9s also a 99.1% pass rate. The grade 10s a 99.6% pass rate, and the grade 11s a 100% pass rate. Secondly, sport. According to the SA Schools Sports website and rankings, and based on the combined results of the 6 main sporting codes in secondary schools, namely rugby, hockey, cricket, soccer, water polo, and basketball, Wynberg Boys was ranked as the number 6 school in South Africa in 2023. Thirdly, cultural activities. The music department had 91 solo entries in the High Stedford, a school record. 7 members of our pie band were invited to join the Cape Town Highlanders in the Freedom of the City Parade. The Wynberg Boys Acting Association took part in the Shakespeare Schools Festival and produced an excellent performance of The Tempest. Some of our talented dramatists performed brilliantly in lead roles in the major production of 2023, School of Rock. A previous production of the school, Twelfth Night, was entered into the International Moscow Drama Festival and won a diploma. In conclusion, should one apply the EFQM Excellence Model to evaluate the performance of the school from the perspective of the 4 enablers and 2 performance outcome indicators, it is evident that Wynberg Boys have enjoyed a very successful year. The leadership guru John C. Maxwell has the following to say about a successful organization, and I quote, "Commitment to continual improvement is the key to reaching your potential and to being successful." Wynberg Boys High finds itself in the cauldron of South African education, and the challenges that all schools currently face are enormous. However, with a philosophy and a vision focused on excellence and learning and innovation, the school will continually strive to set the benchmark for excellence in education in South Africa and beyond. I thank you.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and the prize winners of 2023. We will start the prizes with the grade eights from last year. If I could just ask you, when I read out a group of boys, that you hold your applause until the end of the group. And then for the individual prizes, we can applaud each one. Thank you very much. Grade 8, 2023, subject prizes. Joseph Brading, English. Francois Smith, Afrikaans. Inganati Mbanga, isiXhosa. Attilio Peroni, Mathematics. Jack Jenman, Creative Arts. Braden D'Souza, EMS. Ross Metcalf, Natural Sciences, Technology, and Visual Arts. Teo Adrian, Life Orientation. Joshua Gull, Geography. Matt Richards, Drama, and Ruan Ulofsa, Music. Junior Blues. Blues is awarded to boys who achieve an 80% aggregate at the end of the year. The first group, Adam Haron, Abdul Mutalib Murat, Attilio Peroni, Blake Madel, Braden D'Souza, Brett Gainsford, Caleb Mills, Callum Morrison, Daniel Cooper-Williams, Daniel Essack, Eli van der Merwe, Jack McClear. The second group, Jack Jenman, Jack Rennie, James Gloin, Joshua Eccles, Joshua Gull, Joshua Nicholson, Liam van Lierop, Luke Dennis, Matt Richards, Mikael Peterson, Nadir Sali, Nicholas Stanfleet. The last group of grade 8 junior blues. Noah Bettles, Noah Teague, Away Samai, Philip Powis, Rhys Hill, Ross Metcalf, Ruan Ulofsa, Ryan Needham, Samuel Mocker, Yassine Hendricks. the Mendel Kaplan Awards for the top three students in grade eight, third in grade eight, and receiving junior blues with an aggregate of 84.87, Chinedu Igaligi. Second in grade eight and receiving junior blues and subject prizes for social sciences and history with an aggregate of 85.12, Liam Potter. And first in grade eight and receiving junior blues with an aggregate of 85.22, Aidan van der Vaart. Kennedy. Grade 9 subject prizes. Andre Steele, English. Iko Mechlo, Isikosa. Joshua Edwards, Life Orientation. Luca Neveling, Drama. Junior blues in grade 9. Ahmad Beardin, Adam Uaba, Alexander Hewitt Smith, Andre Steele, Christian Ferguson, Connor Boonzaier, Daniel Wrightford, Danielle Lowe, Dylan Nagel, Elnasi Mariro, Jonathan Mills, Joshua Edwards, Justin Skuman. The next group, Kier Schneidu, Luca Neveling, Matt Brighton, Mikhail Tarantal, Morgan DeBruto, Noah Elger Hedison, Noah Rowan Jacobs, Ross Prinsloo, Thomas Kaywood, Tian Roman, Uzziah Ibrahim, Yatin Naran. Mendel Kaplan Awards for the top three students in grade 9, third in grade 9 and receiving junior blues, and subject prizes for creative arts and visual arts with an aggregate of 88.36, James Orwin. Second in grade 9 and receiving junior blues with an aggregate of 89.19 in absentia, Zach Puerta. First in grade 9 and receiving junior blues and subject prizes for Afrikaans, mathematics, EMS, natural sciences, social sciences, technology, geography, history and music, with an aggregate of 93.10, Luca Caronti. Grade 10 subject distinctions and subject prizes, receiving one certificate. Uchlume Ntiti, Amir Abrahams, Benito Peroni, Christian Gonzalez, Cole Goliath, Ethan Daniels, Godans Kosongo wa Kunutomba, Jack House, Jack Hasty, Kodwa Bobelo, Liema Pahlana, Luca Renz, Lutkobo Guedini, Mohammed Schroeder, Saluddin Anthony, and Xavier Kruger. Boys receiving two certificates. Benjamin Budge, Daniel Price, Dylan Edwards, Iviwe Tatani, including the subject prize for Isitosa, Cameron Reddy, Logan Heath, Paco Reynolds, Seth Amanis, Smamkele Peter, Timothy Sutherland, Tristan Miller, Zakin Croy, Zachary Cape. Three certificates. Adam Yunus, including the subject prize for history. Kian Mosley, including the subject prize for mathematical literacy. James Berger, John T. Albrecht, Michael Roman, including the subject prize for visual arts. Ronan Collin, Suleiman Jabbar, including the subject prize for civil technology construction, and Thomas Zeely. Four certificates, Benjamin Thompson, Chibike Igaligi, including the subject prize for life orientation, Damien Philander, Kane McClure, Mahir Ori, Zuhair Kafar. And while they're coming up, I'll call up five certificates as well. Mohammed Farhan Parker, five certificates. Receiving six certificates, Ashton Bright, James Giles, including the subject prize for accounting, Muhammad Amir Rawut, Ross Bremer, including the subject prize for electrical technology electronics. Seven certificates, Kian Vassen, including the subject prize for economics, Nikolai Conroe, including the subject prize for EGD. Then eight certificates, Christopher Tolyard, including the subject prize for information technology. Academic colors awarded to the grade 10s, Ashton Bright, Benjamin Thompson, Damien Philander, James Giles, Jonty Albrecht, Kian Vassen, Mohammed Farhan Parker, Mohammed Amir Rawut, Nikolai Conroe, Ronan Collin, Ross Bremer, and Zaya Kafar. and Academic Blues in Grade 10 awarded to Christopher Tolyard. The Edward Wise Awards for the top three students in grade 10. Third in grade 10 and receiving academic blues and subject distinctions in English, mathematics, accounting, economics, life sciences, and life orientation with an aggregate of 87.76 Muzamil Solomon. Second in grade 10 and receiving academic blues, subject distinctions for English, Afrikaans, mathematics, life sciences, music, physical sciences, and life orientation, and the subject prize for music with an aggregate of 89.8, Warwick Wilson. First in grade 10 and receiving academic blues, subject distinctions for English, Afrikaans, mathematics, geography, life sciences, physical sciences, life orientation, and further studies mathematics. The Davidovits Prize for grade 10 English and subject prizes for Afrikaans, mathematics, geography, life sciences, physical sciences, and further studies mathematics. With an aggregate of 92.18, Zachary Gibbon. Grade 11 subject distinctions and subject prizes. Receiving one certificate, Jared Fortain, Joshua Peterson, Sebastian de Klerk, Suad Saturin, and Tyrone Gombe. Two certificates is broken up into three groups. So receiving two certificates, Adam Fakir, including the subject prize for visual arts, Adam Jacobs, Adam Modak, Aiden DaCosta, Alex Patterson, Alexander Fernandez, Amir Nordin, Amin Hirdin, Andrew Uester, Benjamin Matthews, Caterin Africa, Caleb Ferreira, Chris Pavard, and Declan Taylor. The second group receiving two certificates, Gabriel Cuttle, Jelle Smuts, Graham Van Sale, Jacques Katsunga, James Hewitt Smith, Joel Flisberg, Johan Faree, Joshua Johannes, Keegan Webb Wilsonach, Levi Wynn, Liam Kent, Liam Clankies, Liam Lester, Liam Montero. The third group receiving two certificates, Luke Flisberg, Luke Honeyman, Michael Sharp, Mulanga Mukatuni, Nadir Daniels, Salih Tashrit, Samuel Lawrence, Tadawanashe Zvapatsa, Timothy George, Tony George, Tristan van Royen, Utman Saban, Uzaya Tregonig, Zalen van Rensburg. The group receiving three certificates, Alexander Mayer, Anelka Chuma, Ashvir Lachman, Daniel Norman, Fayaz Ibrahim, Ilyaz Abrahams, Jack Broom, Jaden Mayer, Jasha Naidu, Joshua Lamberg, Kiam Hendricks, Muhammad Fayad Jacobs, Muhammad Faiz Nordin, Mujahid Januddin, Peter Bonema, Ross Reed, Thomas Roberts, and Zion Edwards.
Go all the way to the edge for me. It's a big group.
The group receiving four certificates, David Faree, David Jones, including the subject prize for civil technology construction, Dayan Brown, Levi Brown, Nathan Preston, Panache Maguera, Samuel Flint, Tariq Eckley, Zach Jacobs. The group receiving 5 certificates: Ethan Lee, Joshua Natus, Luke Andrew, Luke Oldale, including the subject prize for mathematical literacy, and Matteo Caronti. Group receiving 6 certificates: Caleb Danes, including the subject prize for information technology, Damien Hetherington, Daniel Heffron, including the subject prize for music, Ethan Pinn, including the subject prize for accounting, Jacob Punt, including the subject prize for electrical technology electronics, Joel Isaac Stevenson, Liam Story, Michael Funsail, including the subject prize for EGD. Group receiving 7 certificates: Aman Safadin, including the subject prize for Afrikaans, Lihle Swartboy, including the subject prize for isiXhosa, and Luchman Samai. Eight certificates, including the subject prize for geography, Nicholas Buerta. Then receiving academic colors: Caleb Danes, Damien Hetherington, Daniel Heffron, Diane Brown, Ethan Pinn, Ethan Lee, Jacob Punt, Joel Isaac Stevenson, Joshua Natus, Levi Brown, Matteo Caronti, Muhammad Fayyad Jacobs. group receiving academic blues, Aman Safadin, Liam Story, Lihle Swartboy, Lukman Samai, Michael van Sail, Nicholas Buerta. Edward Wise Awards for the top three students in grade 11. Third in grade 11 and receiving academic blues, subject distinctions for English, Afrikaans, mathematics, economics, history, and life orientation, and the subject prize for economics with an aggregate of 87.86%, Matthew Brading. Second in grade 11 and receiving academic blues, subject distinctions for English, mathematics, history, life sciences, physical sciences, life orientation, further studies mathematics, and the subject prizes for English, mathematics, life orientation, history, and further studies mathematics with an aggregate of 88.85, Joshua Gavin. First in grade 11 and receiving academic honors, subject distinctions for English, Afrikaans, mathematics, accounting, life sciences, physical sciences, and life orientation, and the subject prizes for life sciences and physical sciences with an aggregate of 89.88, Farhan Omar. Before I hand over to Mr. Mink to award the prizes to the grade 12 class of 2023, I think just one final round of hearty applause for all those prize winners. And I call on Mr. Mink.
Good evening, everyone. Every year this time, I get a huge lump in my throat at the thought and at the sight of these young men, the matrics of 2023, to say that I'm extremely proud of each and every one of them would be an understatement. It is such a privilege to announce the top 27. 27 of them were awarded honours, they earned it, and I think this is the highest number in recent years. It's been a while since we've had this many. Please note that not all of them are able to be present tonight. Some of them are already in Stellenbosch, having started their courses. I ask that you hold your applause until they are all on stage, and please note that I will still be honouring the boys, the young men, who are not with us this evening. With an average of 79.6, Timothy Sussman in Timothy is here. He will be doing a BSc majoring in computer science and business computing at UCT. Reese Wilson, 80%. Reese is taking a gap year and looking to study in 2025 with an aggregate of 80.29. Diane Bassadin, who is doing a Bachelor of Dental Surgery at the University of the Western Cape on 80.43. Habib Musa, doing a BCom Chartered Accounting at UCT. In absentia, Nicholas van Skalkvik will be doing a degree in Business Science Finance with Accounting at UCT. In absentia, Issa Deshmukh, 80.86, will be doing a Bachelor of Business Science, specializing in Computer Science at UCT. Yusuf Rustin, with an average of 81.14, he will be doing an Islamic course at Darun Naim. Noah Harrison, in absentia, will be doing financial accounting at Stellenbosch University. Zakaria Lunat, also known as Toasty, apparently, will be studying a BCom specializing in financial accounting, the chartered accountant stream at UCT. These courses are so so amazing, I can barely pronounce half of the things here. David Morgenrood, sitting on 81.57%, will be doing a Bachelor of Science, majoring in Computer Science, Data and Statistics at UCT. Kate Stamer, on 81.86, will be doing a Bachelor of Science in Computer Engineering and Computer Science. Luke Bremer, with an average of 82.14, will be studying a Business Science degree in Analytics at UCT. Luca Conero, I believe, is unable to join us this evening, average 82.86, and he is studying Mechatronic Engineering at Stellenbosch. He was unable to come back this evening. Michael Morgan, with an average of 83.29, will be doing a Bachelor of Civil Engineering at Varsity College. Jihad Chilwin, 83.43. Jihad will be studying a BSc in Mechanical and Mechatronic Engineering at UCT. In absentia, Connor Thompson, with an average of 83.57. A Bachelor of Accounting at Stellenbosch University. In absentia, Carl Stevens, 83.71. He will be studying civil engineering at Stellenbosch University. In absentia, Christian Kapp, 83.71. He is doing a Bachelor of Engineering degree at Stellenbosch University. On the last minute, Kevin Ebenezer Karingira let me know that he could not make it this evening. He got it an average of 85%, and he will be studying actuarial science at Stellenbosch University. Joshua Vincent, with an average of 85.14. Joshua will be studying civil engineering at Stellenbosch and training to become a sommelier. Please don't all rush at once. Connor Lowe, in absentia, 85.29%. And he will be studying mechanical engineering at Stellenbosch. Andrew Killick, with an average of 87%, studying a BCom in financial accounting at UCT. Kian Matthews, on 88% average aggregate, Bachelor of Medicine and Surgery at Stellenbosch University. Benjamin Badiali, 89.43%, doing a Bachelor of Science in Data Science and Statistics and Computer Science at UCT. Hamza Lunat is unable to join us tonight. He got an average of 92.29 and will be studying Mechanical Engineering at UCT. Unfortunately, our number two academic, Nas Beertz, is unable to join us. He has an average of 95.43. I have no doubt that Nas is currently getting his books, his files, and his folders in order at the University of Stellenbosch, where he will be studying actuarial science, because that is how we know Nas to be well prepared. Mr. Skip is still some of the limelight earlier when he mentioned all of Jared Benn's accolades. I think they are worthy of a second mention. Jared got 100% for mathematics. He got 100% for physical sciences, also placed first in the country for physical sciences. He was second in the country overall academically. I'm going to mention his English mark as well because I was his teacher. Jared got 93% for English and distinctions in just about everything else, with an average of 96.14% and studying chemical engineering at Stellenbosch. We are extremely proud of these young men, and we know that their results, their commitment, and their excellence will be a shining example for their brothers who are to follow. I now call on Mr. Moser.
Ladies and gentlemen, we are coming around the straight for the final run to the 100-meter line. Your patience is being rewarded. These awards are done on an individual basis now, and they are largely awards for which the boys have not worked specifically. Many of them are awards which they are going to be earning because of their character or their nature. A boy doesn't win a Science Expo prize because he tried to do a better project than everybody else. He doesn't get a service prize because he tried to do more service than every other boy. He doesn't win an all-rounders award because he tried to be better than everybody else at everything he does. This is largely due to his nature, his character, and the values instilled in him by his family. And so this group of people sitting here are actually to be applauded every time a boy comes up here now because of the values that you and your family have instilled in him. And he is just being the best version of himself that you have taught him to be. Congratulations for that. I will read out the boy's name for each award, and he will come up to get his award. And while he's standing here, I will read out his citation. I'm just going to ask that you wait until the citation is over before we start applauding. The first prize is the Rainer Greenwald Prize, which is awarded for the most original history project of the year. It goes to Nathan Preston. Nathan researched police brutality then and now, combining South African history and American history, and brought to light how many things have not changed, especially in America and the southern states. He looked at the case study of Steve Biko, who was murdered in police custody during apartheid, and then went on to research and write on George Floyd's brutal murder in public. The connections were original and the arguments well developed. Well done, Nathan. Next is the Smiley Trophy for the Best Science Expo Project, and it's awarded to Musimil Solomon and Zachary Gibbon. Musimil and Zachary entered into the energy category for the annual ESCOM Science Expo. Boy, do we need them. Their project looked at a comprehensive comparison of diesel and biodiesel as an energy fuel source, and after winning gold medals at the energy category at regionals, as well as the ESCOM Prize for the Best Energy Project, they were selected to take their project to the national competition in Johannesburg. Here they won further gold medals as well as laptop prizes from FFS refiners for the most ingenious use of available material while conducting scientific research experiments in the field of non-renewable energy. This was also the first time that Wynberg had progressed this far in the competition. Well done. The Donald Simons Award is awarded to a grade 10 pupil who's shown the most improvement over his academic performances in previous years, and this year goes to Ronan Cullen. Ronan improved his aggregate by 18.5% between grade 9 and grade 10, and he is now a consistent member of the academic top 20 of his grade. Well done, Ronan. The Stan Jones Prize, awarded to a grade 11 pupil who has shown the most improvement over his performances in previous years at school activities, is awarded this year to Liam Lester. Liam improved his aggregate by almost 17% between grade 10 and 11, and it's clear that Liam has really bought into the Wynberg way since joining us in the middle of his grade 10 year. He's demonstrated this by his willingness to get involved in any aspect of school life, and it really came to the fore at the Nyamazela, the 13-day hike in the Cedarburg, where Liam was often the one motivating his peers to persevere through the challenge. Congratulations, Liam. The Alf Morris Award is awarded to a grade 11 pupil who is an all-rounder, and this year it goes to Shadley Alley. Shadley Shadley is a member of the first 11 cricket side as well as the second 15 rugby. He also serves the school as tenant house prefect, where he has led with aplomb so far, especially considering that tenant is one of the new houses. He's always willing to involve himself in school life and shows great tenacity and perseverance when it comes to achieving across the board at Wynberg. Well done. The Fine Family Bursary is awarded for the second year to Tyron Gombe. Tyron is also a school prefect and a valued member of the first 15, and is apparently the fastest man at the school, having won the 100 meters in sports day. But I believe that there's a staff member who's quicker than him. But nonetheless, Tyron, please come up and get your award. The Anthony Morris Prize, awarded to a grade 8 pupil who has shown the most loyalty to the school by his participation in school activities, is awarded to Samuel Mockey. Samuel had a fantastic start to his high school career, contributing to school life in the following ways: under 14A water polo, under 14B and C hockey, a member of the music department, and being a consistent academic achiever, as showcased by his academic junior blues, which he received earlier tonight. He is also a provincial lifesaver. The David Levitt Memorial Trophy is awarded to the grade 10 pupil. He was an inspiration to all his fellow students. And it goes to Zachary Gibbon. Zach has... Zach has not only enhanced the name of the school during his grade 10 year, but also been one of the emerging leaders of his grade group at Wynberg. He's consistently been the top academic during his high school career, and he gives back to the academic pillar by being a bridging the gap tutor. On the sporting front, he was the only grade 10 to represent Wynberg in the first hockey side last year, and going on to represent Western Province in the winning under 16A IPT hockey side. He was selected as part of the under-16 South Africa high performance team also. He serves the school as part of the committees of his house glebe, as well as the sports committee, and was chosen by his peers as one of the RCL grade reps. He's also on the committee of the RCL. He participates in the service pillar, and his involvement is an inspiration to his peers, but it's his ability to remain a humble and servant-hearted leader, which is something we all admire. Congratulations, Zachary. Zachary tells me that there are only 24 hours in the day, and that's why he stopped playing chess in grade 8. What a pity. The Neil and Cecil Jowell Achiever Award is awarded for demonstrating Wynberg values and given to a boy who has demonstrated significant determination and perseverance, who expresses by his actions that he resonates with the school's values. It is awarded this year to Johan Furrie. Johan is a true Wynberg man, demonstrating values of friendliness, honesty, and integrity at all times. He displays the Supera Moras spirit often, something which can be seen in his climb to be part of the first 15 rugby training squad. Academically, his marks are of a good standard, but what is more notable is his ability to aim high and set goals for himself. He's extremely diligent, does not shy away from hard work, and is an example to his peers. His authenticity makes him a role model who leads quietly at all times. Well done, Jan. And finally, we come to the greatest award that a Wynberg boy could earn, and that is a Supera Moras Award, an all-rounders award. These awards go to the boys who are just the best at everything. There are two unique ties worn by two different Wynberg boys. One is the head boy tie, which obviously can only be worn by one boy. And the other is a tie that is worn by one matric. It's the matric of the week tie. And you saw it earlier this evening when Fayyad Jacobs came up on stage. He was wearing a tie that was different to everybody else's. It is the old Wynberg thin blue and white striped tie. It's something the matrics of a few years back started as a new tradition. And each week, one matric will hand over that tie to another matric in a ceremony which determines who the matric of the week is. So Fayyad is wearing it this week, but there's only one boy who can wear that tie. Well, the Supera Moras tie is probably the next most rare tie that can be worn at Wynberg. There are literally a handful of boys who can achieve this award. Tonight, we have four boys who've earned silver awards and two boys who've earned gold awards. I'll call up the silver awards first and we can congratulate them. Silver awards, Supera Moras, go to Danielle Essek, Adam Uhaba, Francis de Klerk, and Damien Philander. So those boys have earned the equivalent of probably three or four distinctions in every subject, A-team sports, high involvement in culture, and a significant service contribution. The two gold awards would be boys who do all of that, but probably at a provincial level in all four pillars of the school. And the two awards this year go to Chibekwe Egelili and Christopher Tolyard. Thank you. Can you please stand? We're going to end the evening with the school song.